Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain eye diagram. So to explain eye diagram, first I'll explain some basics of eye diagram. Then I'll explain one example how to get eye diagram. Then I'll explain a basic eye diagram display. And then at the end, I'll sum up this session based on how many parameters that we can interpret based on eye diagram. So let us begin this session with basics of eye diagram. So see, eye diagram summarizes the effect of ISI by showing a response of zeros and ones. So eye diagram, that is summarizing effect of inter-symbol interference, and how it summarizes effect of inter-symbol interference, that I'll explain in eye diagram basics as well as in diagram of eye diagram. So we will see it later. See, eye diagram can be generated by overlaying plots of received signal for every symbol time period. So that even I will be explaining, like, see how we can generate eye diagram by having every symbol time period by overlaying on each other. And the resultant plot of eye diagram that looks like eyes, that's why it is called as eye diagram. So let us try to understand this eye diagram by one example, so it will be more clear. Now see, here we have NRZ polar coding, and if the bit stream that is given by 1 0 1 0 1 0, so if bit stream that is given by this, in that case if you observe the waveforms, then that will appear like this. For 1 it will be high value, and for 0 it will be negative value. For polar, for 1 it is high value, for 0 it will be negative value. For 1 it is high, and for 0 it will be negative value. That is how ideally NRZ polar signal will appear. Now see, if we want to plot eye diagram, then how to plot it? So this is ideal waveform. Now for ideal waveform, if we want to plot eye diagram, then we need to consider first of all bit period. So here if you see bit period, that is starting from 0 to TB, then for second bit it is there from TB to 2 TB, from third bit it is there from 2 TB to 3 TB. That is how time period is there. So if I make time period like this, which is having bit period TB, and here by vertical axis if I show magnitude, where this is 0 magnitude, this line that shows you 0 magnitude, and here it is maximum magnitude, and here it is minimum magnitude. So to plot diagram, first if I say from 0 to TB, it is having magnitude 1, which is appearing like this. So let us plot that here. So that magnitude that appears like this. Now for 0, if you see pulse which is appearing like this, so I need to plot that pulse. For 1 it is happening like this, I'll have to plot it like this. For 0 it is happening like this. So this is how I can plot a magnitude over here by amplitude. By this axis there is amplitude, and by this axis there is time, and that time period which is there with one bit only, that is TB. But this is what ideal signal which we are receiving right now. But if we see practical signal, then practical signal will not be like this. The reason is, when you send that signal over channel, because of channel is band limited, there will be some noise which will get added with this original information. So your original signal will not appear like this, as you can see it over here, but it may be having some distortion. Let us have some distortion signal which we receive compared to this identical signal. So my distorted signal that may appear like this. So I have drawn distorted signal over here. Now to have eye diagram plot, all I need to do is I need to plot this distorted bits over here in this display. So if you see first bit that is happening like this, so I'm just plotting it, you can see for this second bit which is 0, that is actually received by this magnitude pattern. So I'm just drawing it here. For this bit it is happening like this, this bit that is happening like this, this bit that is happening like this, this bit that is happening like this. So see, this is how all the bits that we are overlaying on each other in a single diagram of bit duration TB. So if you see this diagram looks like I. If you see this diagram, that looks like I. So this diagram looks like I. That's why it is called as I diagram. That's why it is called as I diagram. Now see how many things that we can understand from this diagram. So from this diagram we can understand, if you see the maximum I opening, so maximum I opening that is happening over here. At this instant of time, at this instant of time, I opening is maximum, and as you go in either direction, I opening is decreasing. So as I opening is decreasing, you can say inter symbol interference is maximum. So maximum I opening that is happening over here by this line, I have shown it over here. So that line, that is what justifying where I need to take decision of given sample. So this instant, that is what decision making sample position. So this instant where I opening is maximum, that is what decision making of bit. So decision making instant, that we can say. So this instant is decision making instant. And if noise is more in received signal, then you will be finding this I opening that will decrease. So opening of I, that will justify amount of inter symbol interference. So higher the opening of I, lower the inter symbol interference. So let me mention this point even. I opening shows inter symbol interference ISI. Higher the opening, lower the ISI. So higher the opening of this I, lower the inter symbol interference, and lower the opening of this I, higher the inter symbol interference, that will happen in received data. So that is what we can understand based on this one example, how we can get I diagram. Now when you see your textbook, you will be finding this kind of diagram that is given to you. So that is what I diagram, where for ones, if I say bit is high, then you will be finding for one, this is what decision making boundary that is there with you, and for zeros, this is what decision making boundary by this red color that one can say. And here if you see this instant, so at this instant I opening is maximum, at this instant I opening is maximum, so we can say this is based sampling instant. So this is based sampling instant. Now here if I say decision, that is what we are doing it with respect to zero voltage. So if I say over here, this is what zero voltage. So this is what decision floor. So with respect to this, we are taking decision. Now here, if you see this gap, so this gap that is showing amount of distortion which is happening to take decision with one, and this magnitude, this shows you amount of magnitude which is giving you idea about distortion of zero. So this is what distortion of one. And this is distortion of zeros. Now see, this is the instant where we have maximum opening of eye. So that is what best sampling instant, where this amount of magnitude, that is what margin up to which we can receive signal without error. So this is what this gap, that is what showing you margin over noise. So this is margin over noise. Now if you see some other data, so one more data that we can see, that is what slope of this. So slope of this, that shows you sensitivity of timing. Slope of this, that will show you sensitivity of timing. So this slope, that shows you sensitivity of timing. Now see, this slope, as I have told you, that is what giving you idea about sensitivity of timing. Now what is sensitivity of timing? So that we can understand based on what is jitter. Now when you receive any signal in digital system, then you'll be finding it is there in terms of ones and zeros. So you'll be finding one bit, that is what represented like this, and bit zero, that is what represented like this. But practically when you observe this edge, so that edge, that is not this sharp as you can see, but it will be having somewhat slope. So practically it will be happening like this with some slope. And because of this kind of slope is there, you'll be finding this slope which is appearing in eye diagram. If you have this sharp edges, in that case you'll be finding there is no, that slope will be completely vertical. But practically it is not happening. Practically there is some jitter which is getting added in received signal, and that's why that slope is happening like this, and that shows you sensitivity of timing. Now if you see this gap, so that gap, that shows you distortion of timing. This gap, that shows you distortion of timing. So you should not take sampling at this instant, it should be at maximum eye opening, where you will be finding best sampling instant, and your decision will be good if you take sampling at best sampling instant. So if you go over here, in that case you'll be finding your signal is getting distorted. So this is distortion of timing. Similarly over here, even distortion of timing that is happening. And this complete one bit, and here in this you'll be finding this distance from here to here, that is one bit distance, one bit time. So this distance in between this two line, that is what one bit timing. So these are the parameters which will justify what is eye diagram. Now let us try to understand how many things that we can interpret based on eye diagram. So see, width of eye opening, so width of eye opening, that will justify time interval over which received signal, received distorted signal can be sampled with minimum error. So at this instant we can receive signal with minimum distortion. So that is what we can justify based on this eye opening. So higher the eye opening, less the distortion which is possible in received signal. So width of eye opening will justify inter-symbol interference, whether it is less or more. Second parameter, that is sensitivity of the system to the timing. So if you increase data rate, eye opening that will get decrease. So if you increase data rate, you will be finding eye opening will decrease. So as you increase data rate, eye opening will decrease. So sensitivity of timing, that even we can justify, that is what slope of this. So slope of this will decrease as you increase rate of data. So by increasing rate of data, slope of this will decrease. If slope of this will decrease, eye will get close. So opening of eye, that will get close like this. So sensitivity of system of timing, that we can justify. And third is margin over noise. So this width of opening of eye, that will justify margin over noise. So this many interpretation that we can have it based on eye diagram. I hope that you have understood this session. Please give your reply on comments. I have made this session based on request of one of my student. I hope that he have understood, and this will be beneficial to some other students even. Thank you so much for watching this video.